because we have so many rules about how to do this. And I feel like spirituality has really evolved, you know, mm-hmm. from this guru mentality, from needing to meditate in lotus position, sitting straight with your back, you know, all these rules. And I think, yeah, do you think, I want to ask you, that spirituality is really different now and that that is also evolving, like spiritual teachings?
Yeah, I just wrote in my journal yesterday something like, conformity is like an FU to God, because when instead of conforming to some spiritualized idea or belief structure that seems right because all the right people are saying this is what you have to do and this is what the books are telling you and everything, but your inside or your body, like this thing that the creator created, this body, which is a direct portal into the greatest level of devotion, if we go against ourselves because we're trying to do the right thing, it's actually the furthest thing from spirituality, because being spiritual is being authentic. It's like when I look at a flower, I have some of my deepest mystical experiences just sitting in present, looking at a blade of grass or a flower or the light streaking through a tree as I'm sitting. And that flower isn't like, oh my God, I'm too yellow or I'm too this, or like, I should be stronger like a tree. Like, let me like try to be something else. Or, oh God, who am I to receive all this water? How unspiritual to take so much. Like, let me go into a drought so that others, you know, don't judge me as greedy or whatever. That doesn't happen in nature. It just happens in our humanness. And I don't want to get into like the origins of that or why it's the way it is. But I think that the deepest level of spirituality is receiving what you need to flourish and releasing the constructs, the mental constructs that say you have to be good. You know, one of my spiritual teachers, and I'll dive into that a little more deeply, we're already innately good. So when I say that, I don't mean be a jerk or like be, you know, do horrible things. What I mean is most people I'm watching this right now, we're just innately good. We're drawn to deep thinking and spiritual connection and creating something beautiful in the world and helping others, serving others. Like, the goodness is here. Like, it's here. It's not something we have to add to ourselves. But what one of my guides said to me once when I was really struggling with good girling and trying to play perfect and, you know, all these, trying to be putting so much emphasis on the mask, he said, Veronica, you're not here to be good. And I was like, what? Because you're not here to be good. You're here to be real. That is the meaning of your life. And I was like, you know, like everything just started popping. I was like, what do you mean I'm not here to be good? Like I had to really, it felt like a shattering of my false North Star. And he goes, you already are good. That's what you are. But who is the real Veronica? Who is the real Veronica? And what I've discovered are many things. I'm a very sensual person. I love luxury. I deeply enjoy delicious foods. I love being in a body. I love being emotional and human and a little crazy. I am not this like, you know, male yogi in a cave, which I tried so hard to be for so many years because my mom had a lot of emotional instability, went homeless, and my dad was like the perfect father and so zen and so stable. And so I tried to emulate his perfection. And it could like bring me to tears because that's such a painful thing, not just for us, but for the source that created us, because it's like not delivering upon what we're here to deliver upon, which is to be real, to be fully ourselves. And we know inside, because it makes us feel expansive. We feel so alive and so good. And I don't mean the kind of alive that's like, I just had 16 cocktails. I feel amazing. And then you feel horrible the next day. Not that. I mean, wow, like I'm deeply, deeply called to, you know, connect with my body and to, you know, start to explore these deep mystical experiences, or I really want to eat this thing. It feels so delicious and nourishing to my system, to this particular prakriti or constitution I have. Like, these are the things to start basing our spiritual path based on authenticity and alignment, rather than dictation from somebody who claims to have a direct line to God. What I discovered in that moment is that we have the direct line to God. If I'm not mistaken, Yeshua the Christ actually said, God is within you. The power is within you, right? So it sounds basic or simple, but it is so, can be easy to forget that when there's so many authorities out there and we've been programmed from the moment we were born to believe that the power is outside. Everything in our society is literally designed to make, to migrate us from knowing our immensity, being our immensity, to fear and getting permission from somebody out there to say you're valid or you're worthy or, you know, you deserve to be here. Mm. So how do we actually awaken to that? That, like, it's almost like opening the door, getting that skeleton key that unlocks the door to who we actually are. For me, it happened in a moment of doing all the wrong things. Like, it happened just following that, and mostly out of really big pain. And I just want to say to anyone who's having a really painful experience right now, like I was waking up in the middle of the night, I'm a deep sleeper. So that was like extremely disorienting to be waking up at night panicked, like, oh my God, like it was like just systemic. Like it was like my whole being was like, I don't belong here. What are the, like, I just felt like I was unraveling. And I just want to say that was my limited identity unraveling. And so if you are earnest with your path and you immerse yourself in, like for me, it was I Am That in certain books that did help me and continue to help me seep in the truth of who I am, surround myself with certain people, only let into my mind those things that are nourishing to my heart, body, and soul. That if you're earnest with your path and you're choosing freedom, spiritual liberation, wholeness, prosperity, being an instrument of grace, being an instrument of truth, and you're continuing to feed that, whether it's meditation, yoga, whatever your practices are, ecstatic dance, sitting with your mentor, coach, being in beautiful memberships like Yannicka's membership, Wisdom from North. These things are a way of communicating that I mean business. Like I'm here to be whole. And the soul's goal is nothing but to be whole. The soul's goal is wholeness. So in those little actions of, I honor myself, I trust myself, I take these actions that support my awakening and what feels aligned, holy, and true for me, something happens beyond the pain. The pain is a doorway into this liberation that we came here for. So I just want to say that to anyone who's suffering right now. I know it's easier said than actually moving through it. And I look back and I'm like, God, if I hadn't gone through that time, if I had given up, which I really wanted to be honest, I would have missed out on my life. Like I just moved to a new country. I swim like many days a week. I am absolutely in love with my life. I love my business. I love serving the clients I serve. I absolutely love my body, my life, my relationships, my health, where I live, the freedom I've created. So spirituality isn't just these deep states. It's also weaving that in, threading it through our human experience. And that means the mess. Because combined with this gorgeous experience, it's also been a great challenge moving to another country and all the decisions and like you know, just all the challenges. But the juiciness of that girl I was in the Redwoods, finally waking up to, oh my God, I'm anxious, I'm confident, I'm insecure, I'm joyful, I'm peaceful, I'm all of it. All of that humanness, being present with it all, is how we thread the spiritual path into our humanity. And then the human experience sort of takes care of itself, if that makes sense, once we're married to who we really are.
To watch the full video, click the link below, and I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel.